I realised that the microphone isn't working or isn't on. If anyone can't hear me, put your hand up. I'm deaf.
I'm me.
I'm sure that if 500 people on the parade ground in camp can hear me, I'm sure you can hear me. I did ask Peter to let me have some details of his autobiography.
Oh, yes, yes. Yes. It's only 661 pages.
It's all right, I cut it down.
Oh, how disappointing.
We all know what it's like, don't we? Peter Charles Carter. What a beautiful name. I like the Charles bit.
I never did until Prince Charles came on the scene, you know. And then I thought it was a bit more classy.
There's no stopping him. Peter was born in Slot, Cardiff, in the Morrison Air Raid Shelter. How wonderful. He was a war baby. So he's years younger than me, no? You meant the last war, did you? Not the one before.
No, the boy.
He was born to musical parents, a lyrical tenor and his accompanist. After a year or two of being taught the piano by a Mrs. Hale, Peter could just struggle through Handel's Largo. The rest of his piano skills were self-taught, except that Mother would come in with flour on her hands to ask that he might observe the F sharp at the end of that bar. At 16, he was taught organ at Llandaff Cathedral by Kenneth Turner and then Robert Joyce, who used to play for us when I was in college at Llandaff. No, Robert. He was an active organist at both school and college and has held organist and choirmaster posts at St. John the Baptist Church, Sully, Warwick Road Congregational Church, Coventry, and St. Nicholas Parish Church, Kings Norton, Birmingham, where it is said he did his best work for 70 years. His best work. Oh, you went downhill then?
I'm downhill. Definitely downhill.
Why ever did he come here? He gained the Associateship of Royal College of Organists in 1972. He was until recently organist at St. Michael's Pembrin for 30 years and St. Llandaff's Church, Kenarth, for 11 years, and since January this year has been organist and choirmaster here at St. Hilarys Church, and for this he drives 132 miles on pilgrimage every Sunday. But we've noticed. I must say, we appreciate his music on Sundays. Peter has taught tens of thousands of pupils over 30 years, the last of which now 30 years old, and the very first 63. He has conducted several oratorios, operettas, choirs and orchestras, and has directed many shows and pantomimes. He is a member of the Kilgarran Players, a dramatic group named Seesaw, and sings bass in the Reverend Jonathan's St. Cledwin Singers. On the 29th of July, he was the improvisatory pianist in The Master and His Maid, and a Hilarys acted silent film performed in the Regency Hall, Saundersfoot. His catalogue of compositions and arrangements runs to 9 pages, mostly for church use. He is the author of 3 unpublished books. Is this something to do with the law?
No, no. The third is my autobiography.
The law that you cannot publish after your death.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
No, I wouldn't like anybody. I wouldn't like anybody to read this until after I've gone.
I thought perhaps you'd written something libelous.
Maybe right.
No one can be mayor. Next Friday, he is giving another organ recital at Llanhewy Belfry, a rural church that is very difficult to find. But those of you who will find it, and who goes, will have to pay £10 a ticket. And you, my friends, are very lucky tonight, because it's free. Would you bring round the collection plate? Whoever's doing the collection now. And after the collection has been taken, we will then go on to the second part of this lovely program this evening.